another Junky Spot review. Today I'll be doing the review on the brand new ABS Hujoo Boy Leo. He is 45 centimeters tall. His head circumference is going to be a 7 to 8. The eyes he's going to be using is going to be an 18 to 20 millimeter eye. The chest circumference that he has is a 17.5 centimeter circumference. His waist is going to be at 15 centimeters. He's got hips at 19 centimeters. And his foot is at 6 centimeters. So right now what I have before you all is the full set version. There's two versions. You can actually get a blank version or you can get the full set version. Full set version is pretty cool. He will come with the face up. He'll come with a random pair of eyes, a wig, clothing, which will include the clothing that he's wearing right now, and then you also get the horns. So these are the horns that he will come with if you get the full set. They're already like pre-blushed and whatnot, and the magnets are included. I actually do have another review about just the fantasy parts that Hujoo sells, and they're super duper awesome. I totally recommend that you check that out if you want to see that video. There's a link right here for it, so please feel free to check that out as well. So our full set Leo is pretty interesting. They had been holding out on us for a while. They had the Hujoo Dana, they had the Sarah, then they had a whole bunch of other ones like the Tiara and like Yomi and like a whole bunch of other gals. And so finally now we get to see a boy. The super duper cool thing about our boy is that they did make him to where he can coincide with the other gals. So if you have a Hujoo Dana, if you have a Hujoo Sarah, he is going to be taller than the girls. Here's the girl and boy side by side. So you can see there's like a height difference even when they're sitting here. So very super duper nice, because I know sometimes you kind of have to, you know, guess when it comes to your boys and your gals. Hopefully, you know, that one will be shorter than the other, but if you want your girl to be taller, whatever, that's a whole completely different other thing. But just to like kind of show you that, you know, this is the girl version that they make. These are the girls, this is the Dana, and so now we have here our boys. I'm so excited. So now we have a Leo. There's another sculpt also, which his name is Matthew, and he's available on the site as well. So I highly recommend that you check out the Junky Spot so you can see him too. But today we have the Leo. So I wanted to make sure that you guys got a close-up look at everything, including the face-up and the clothes that he's wearing for the full set here. So if you want to just take a quick look at our face-up here, it is actually a really pretty-looking face-up. It has the eyelashes there. It's got very pretty-looking lips. So his jacket, there's really, really nice detailing on the jacket here. It's got some lining inside. Really, really nice looking. He's got like a tank top underneath. He's got his pants here, which it's a little button that closes the pants here. Some more detailing here. There's like a zipper that's added here, and it can work. The zipper here can work also. Here you can actually zip up the jacket too. Moving down, you got pants. Really nice looking boots. They've got like a tie here. Got these little chains that are hanging off the sides of them here. Little crosses on them. They can untie. So if you don't want them to be tied this way, you can tie them another way if you want. So it's just like, it's just lace, it's straight up lace. So now that you've kind of seen a more up close look of what he looks like, the full set clothing that he has, you saw the optional parts that he has, let's go ahead and take a look at the body and let's see what it looks like, because our boys are now different, because you know the girls, you know, they're girls, so now we got boys. Not that we're looking at that, but you know what I mean. So let's do some movie magic and let's get him undressed. So you'll notice that our new Hujoo boys that we have here have very similar jointing in the arms and the legs as that of our Hujoo, you know, girls that we have, the Sarah and the Dana and the rest of those ladies. They have pretty much the same jointing structure. I mean, the main key difference, of course, is going to be our torso area. It's got a male torso attached to it. Other than that, I mean, the hands also are a bit different than our ladies' hands that we have. So, I mean, it's going to be pretty much like the same structure as our previous Hujoo, you know, 1/4 scale dolls. It's just that torso that's going to be kind of one of our main differences for obvious reasons, you know. The default face-up is, like I mentioned before, it's really nice. I think it's a, you know, I don't want to say pretty, but I mean, that's what I think of. That's the first word that comes to my mind when I you know, think of the company face-up. So, but this is the default company face-up for the Leo. You can order them blank, so if you want to do your own face-up or if you want to commission somebody else to do one, that is certainly an option for you to choose. When we open up our head, you do notice that this is where our elastic is located, the end pieces of it, and then we have this ring. Very similar to the other rings that we have inside of the Hujoo Dana and the Hujoo Sarah, except since this is a faceplate type system, they have a different kind of neck piece incorporated into this. So you'll see that it kind of looks like an open C. It's got a C here, and like here's the open part of the mouth here. This right here, the reason why there's even an opening here to begin with is that if you do happen to have to, you know, take off the head, you want to take the back plate off for some odd reason, or if you're going to change out strings or whatever your reason may be, you're going to have to essentially turn this. You'll turn it like a key. It'll drop down here, and luckily, you know, since they have the ring in place here, your strings are not just going to go flying down into the body, and then you can go ahead and do whatever you need to do. Now, if you need to put it back, you're going to slide the pieces right back through. You can pull up on your string, and you're going to make sure that when you do pull it back through, that it's sitting back this way to where it's like perpendicular. That way, because if you have it facing the other way, it's obviously not going to lock because it's going to slide through that open mouth part. But you do want to make sure that this is facing the right way. Now, I was honestly, to be honest with you all too, I was kind of concerned because I was like, well, what is stopping this from going through this point here? I think it's strung just right to where it's tight enough to where it's not going to move the ring anyway. Like, it's not going to shift it and unlock it, essentially. So, I mean, as you can see, I'm moving it around. I'm moving around pretty, you know, roughly. And it's not moving from that position. So, I think, you know, as long as you have it facing this way, going this way, right here, up and down, you're going to be safe. You're not going to have to worry about the ring falling through the neck piece or anything like that. But it is interesting that they've changed this a couple of times now from the other Hujoo dolls that we've seen. And then definitely they're moving into this faceplate system type deal versus just having the head cap. So anyway, that's pretty much what this is. And of course, these strings here are the ones that are poking out here. These are for the legs. The arms have their own loop of elastic that are strung into the arms. Pretty much just like any other dolls that we have, when you string them, you have a loop of elastic for the arms, you have a loop of elastic for the legs, and for, like, it goes through the torso here as well. So let's take a closer look at our head cap that we have, or I guess the faceplate that we have here. It has that silicone piece that keeps in your eyes. So essentially you can take this out, and you'll see we have our stem eyes that are put into place here. This is why I know in other videos I've recommended, and I've always said that, you know, if you're going to be using this type of system with the silicone eye holder piece, that it's really good to have stem eyes, because when you do, you can just stick them in there. Right now, I know they're not facing like any particular way that I probably want them to be, but when you put it in, see how I'm pushing it in, la 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 la. When you push it in, and when you're going to get ready to position the eyes, all you have to do is actually, because you don't want that to happen, all you have to do is just move around the stem, and you can position it to a different area, and it keeps it in place. So I think that's pretty innovative. That's pretty cool what they decided to do there on this little system that they have implemented for the eyes. So I'm going to go ahead and put back our faceplate onto our head here. And so all you're going to do is you're going to find your P
pieces, the pegs. You're going to press it together. Make sure you do a nice press so that way it can click. It'll hold it in there. So you'll see no more gaps. It's done. The head is in there, and now we can take a look at our head and see how it moves. So range of motion for a head is actually really, really nice. We have a very, very nice ability to look up. That's our extent right there. We can look down. We can do side to side. You can, of course, swivel left and right. And then, of course, we just have like a set forward position here. If you want more of like a solid, movement, I guess, without it maybe perhaps shifting at all, you could put, hot glue suede. Just be careful whenever you're doing hot glue suiting with these dolls since they're made out of ABS. I've actually done some tutorials on hot glue suiting, but, just make sure that you're not going to be directly putting the hot glue onto the ABS itself. I would suggest first putting it on something else and then smearing it into the joint area. I've done that actually for my Hujoo Dana. I suaded the torso joint here so that way I could have her, at a more just solid position here, because sometimes when I'm playing with her, moving her around, that she likes to go back a little bit. So I put that hot glue suading here, and she actually just kind of sits here now, unless I actually physically move it here. But anyway, moving on to our arms for our Hujoo boy here. It's going to be very similar to that of our Danas and the rest of our, ladies that we have, the 1/4 scale dolls. They have the gear systems put into place. That's so it will click into different positions if you're moving the arm up. It gives it traction there. If you were to pull this apart from our shoulder here, when you pull it apart even more, you'll notice that inside there they put like a silicone piece inside of there, so that way when you're doing shifting of the arm, it's doing it smoothly, and it'll also hold the arm into place. It's all that stuff that's put into place there is just for traction, and also so you can, have better posing abilities with it. Nothing's going to slip and slide for you. So if you have the arm positioned here, it's going to stay there. If you have it here, it's going to stay there. It's all these different things are incorporated for posing. The inside of our arm here where our elbow is also implemented with our gears here. It can click once for a like 90 degree type angle. You can click it again here and then it bends the elbow. When it's bent at this angle, he's able to touch his face. Our wrists and our hands have a two-part system. It has the part here so you can see where our hook is for our hand. So if you need to unhook the elastic for the arms, it's there. You have this floating middle piece here that is in the wrist, so it helps increase mobility as well. I was playing with this earlier and I noticed that it can actually hinge itself on the edge here, and it can lock it there as well. I don't know if, you would have any use for that, but, that's just something interesting I just looked at right now. So yeah, it has different hands from the girls though, for sure. This hand is a lot different than what we have for our girls. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you my girl that I have. I have a Hujoo Dana here. So the one with the pink nails is obviously my Hujoo Dana, and then this one here is our boy. So I mean, they did different sculpting in our hand. It looks like our girl's hand is a little bit more feminine and a different little feminine position. The guy's is a little bit more kind of open, I guess you could say. And they look to be roughly the same size. They made the girls' hands a little bit slender at the tips than they did for the boys here. So not everything is the same when it comes to the arms and the feet and whatnot for the girls and the boys. Our torso is the next place I want to go ahead and take a look at with you all. They gave him a muscular looking torso. You can definitely see some definition here. You can see that there's rib definition on the sides here. Got a bit of a seam line here. Once again, like I think I mentioned in another video, if it's truly bothersome, you could attempt to sand it off. But I mean, most of the time it'll be under clothes, and honestly, since it's at the side here, it's not too noticeable, really. When you go down to the bottom of our torso, where our hips are, we've obviously got man parts down there. But they actually also added some definition lines here as well, which I thought was kind of interesting for our boy. Looking at our torso, it's a little bit different. I noticed when I pulled it apart that it had these I guess these little pieces that kind of jut out. But when you look at the inside of it, it's got the holes here that, you know, that they slide into. I think that's just mainly there so he can keep his position a little bit more locked, straightforward. You can shift it up to an extent. It has to jump over those locks though. But you do get this kind of gap forming here. Same thing with this here. But I mean, I'm not quite sure why you would, I mean, position it all the way back like that or facing forward. Moving down to our hips, once again, you'll notice that we have those gears that we had inside of our other 1/4 scale dolls. So there's a gear right there if you slide it apart. That, of course, is so it can click and it can lock into place whenever you're moving it around. It'll hold it. It won't slide around if you have that there. As far as sitting goes, he can sit at a straight position here. Inside of our swiveling thigh, however, they do have that lip there that you can go ahead and hinge it on like this. So he could have a leg that's kind of popping up like this. It's on, of course, both of our legs here. So you would essentially just slide it into there. And then there you go. He can kind of like sit up like this. It does look kind of weird without any clothes on, but I mean, if you had clothes on, I mean, it might look a little bit different for you, but I just think it's interesting that they did that, for our legs here. So they do give you an option other than just sitting straight forward like this. They give you that option of putting it in this hinge here. So that way he can do a different sitting position. But also, if you noticed here, they do have the ridges here as well. That's because, you know, it'll add traction to your swiveling thigh. So you'll notice it's not perfectly smooth. That's because it'll move to those different positions. I don't know if you can hear that. It's sliding into the different slots. That way your swiveling thighs are not like swiveling everywhere. Very, very cool mechanics. I mean, it's very similar to our other ones that we have. Looking into our knees, it's very similar to that of our elbows. If you were to pull this apart, you can see that it has the gears here as well. You can go ahead and it can click once here. You can click it again and it bends it completely this way. Our feet are very similar to that of our wrists. It has a floating piece in the middle here and then it has the hook down here. Once again though, you'll notice that they have different little pieces that have different ridges and cuts to them that correspond with other parts inside of the doll here. So that's just something that kind of locks it into position. If you're clicking it this way, it'll move to that cross line. If you move it back this way, it'll slide into that cross line there. So everything, you know, was kind of built with a purpose. Even down here, you can see that there's small itty bitty, I don't know if you can see that there. You can see there's itty bitty holes with itty bitty pieces that are sticking out of the bottom part of our foot here. And those are so that it can slide into those parts there and it keeps it solid. If everything is snapped in correctly, you'll notice that everything kind of flows nicely. The foot, I mean, as far as articulation goes and how it can move and everything, it's really nice. I think it's a smart move for them to have that jointing down here so that way it's ensured that it's locked into position when you're standing. And that pretty much covers it for today's review. So I hope this helped anybody that had questions about the Hujoo Leo, which is our new Hujoo boys, and the 1/4 scale region of these dolls. Very, very cool guy. Super duper excited to do the review for him. If you guys have any other questions, feel free to leave your comments or questions in the bar below. If you want to see more on these awesome, cool dolls, please go ahead and visit the site. That's www.junkyspot.com. As always, I hope you guys have a fantastic day, and we will see you all in another review. Bye!